Thank you, Carl. Well, 19,000 refugees on temporary visas will become permanent residents. The coalition is slamming the move, accusing the government of risking a fresh wave of boat arrivals.
We are running Operation Sovereign Borders. The people who are getting their visas have been here for over 10 years. Anyone who's come in the last 10 years and anyone who comes today, tomorrow, next week, next month, next year, yeah, will not be allowed to settle in Australia. Full stop.
It's sparked fresh debate, and refugee Abdul Noori joins us now in Canberra, as well as human rights advocate Craig Foster, who is here in the studio with us. Hello, Craig. Abdul, I want to come to you first. Now, you've been living in limbo for those 10 years that Bill Shorten spoke about there after fleeing Afghanistan as a teenager. I know that alone must have been a harrowing journey for you.
It has. Coming over here, like, as a teenager, as a young boy over here, it's been extremely difficult, but here I am. So we, unfortunately, were like in the circumstances that we had to make a choice of, yeah, whether we want to leave over there or want to risk our life to for a better future.
And I think anyone who knows a bit about Afghanistan knows just how challenging the circumstances were there for people like you, Abdul. This change now, this access to permanent residency, what does that mean for you? What kind of a change will that have to your life?
With, like, people like myself, we've gone through, like, so many difficult things. The 10 years being in limbo and not having hope for the future, that's, it's, like, it damages you, like, mentally and, like, physically. Like, it's tough to go through, like, what we have gone through. And no one should go through this. But it means a lot. Like, I can say, like, it means so much to me, but I don't know. It's I'm still praising, like, the news is out there, but again, like, with immigration, like, we've gone, like, back and forth so many times with these policy that I, like, it's hard for us to believe until we actually see the changes, until we actually see people holding those visa.
Gee, it's heartbreaking when you hear those kinds of stories, Craig, isn't it? Because these people have been so challenged in their lives, the reason they came here, and to still for 10 years not quite know what really the future holds for them. I mean, we've heard the rhetoric from the coalition government, sort of the coalition opposition, saying that this is going to encourage opportunities for people smugglers, that we're going to see a new wave of boat, and obviously no one wants to see deaths at sea again. You know, do you think there is a way of doing this safely?
Well, great to see you. And firstly, just to Abdul, look, I'm so pleased for him and to the other 19,000 people. You know, we have terms that we use in this country and have used and have developed over the last 20 years, whether it's illegal or family reunification and these types of things that we always read all the time. But actually, it's just about people. Yeah. And, you know, you're talking about mothers and fathers, wives and husbands, children who are now going to be able to reunite after 10 years. That's extraordinary. So it's a huge amount of emotion yesterday. So I congratulate the government, Albanese government, on this, and Andrew Giles and Claire O'Neill and so on. Now, for the rest of Australia, what's important is that after 20 years of harming people, that we just take this moment to breathe and have a moderate discussion, which we're capable of doing. Mm. Hopefully, we can see that we are moving on from that period. And this decision yesterday is a really important moment in that. There's still many people who are still here, you know, post-2013 and so on, but this is a really important step. But as the Albanese government have been saying, you know, their operation on water is still there. Mm. So what's important is that we can have this conversation without all the hyperbole. And yesterday we're talking about already an armada of boats and all of this type of rubbish that we've lived through. The fear-mongering has to stop. Surely we can just have a reasonable discussion. Albo yesterday said, you know, you can be strong on borders without being weak on humanity. Yeah. I'd like him to say we can be strong on humanity without being weak on borders. Once we turn that around, we know we're going somewhere.
Yeah, it's really about finding that middle ground, isn't it? Craig, exactly. Thank you so much. And Abdul, all the best for you as well.
You're in Newcastle this morning. Good vantage point to spot those refugee boats coming. Are you concerned about that at all?
Oh, yeah. You stay up too late reading some of those crazy blog sites. No refugee boats here. In all seriousness, though, what we're doing is we're maintaining Operation Sovereign Borders. Boat turnbacks will be aggressively maintained. People smugglers who are trying to prey opportunistically on vulnerable people, you're not welcome. You will be stopped, full stop.
Okay, Neil, is it a moth to the flame?
But But how are you continuing Operation Sovereign Borders when you're dropping the TPVs, the temporary protection visas? There were three strands to that: turn back the votes, the TPVs, and offshore detention. Now you're dropping one of those strands. It has to run a risk, Bill. There's a gamble here. And already the people smugglers are looking at it closely and say, the deal might have changed in Australia. You are running a risk. You can't say you're continuing the same operation. You're not. You're dropping one of the planks.
Just quickly on that, Bill.
We are running Operation Sovereign Borders. The people who are getting their visas have been here for over 10 years. Anyone who's come in the last 10 years, and anyone who comes today, tomorrow, next week, next month, next year, will not be allowed to settle in Australia. Full stop.
Okay.